Mr. True, or mean. Bam! Anyway, we're going to be talking about in this video the mean value theorem, which is very similar to the Rolle's theorem, except where the Rolle's theorem is specifically saying that a function value is, if the function's value is the same at two values of a and b, then the, you know, that would create a secant line which is horizontal. And it says within that interval that there is a value c that makes the first derivative equal to zero as well. Or basically we're saying if there's a horizontal secant line, then somewhere within that interval we can have a, or we'll find a horizontal tangent line if we have a continuous function and one which is differentiable. The mean value theorem will say something that sounds very similar, but we don't have to have slopes equal to zero. If f is continuous on the closed interval of ab and it's differentiable on the open interval of ab, then there exists a number c, and remember we're talking about independent variables, x values. There's this other point within that interval of c, within that interval, such that f prime of c, remember derivative, slope, so the instantaneous slope, f prime of c, or the instantaneous rate of slope, the slope of the graph at that point, is equal to the function f of b minus f of a over b minus a, which we should be recognizing as just an average rate of change formula. So what does that mean? That the instantaneous rate is equal to the average rate of change. Well, I've drawn a continuous and smooth curve going from a to b. That means the fact that it's smooth means it's differentiable. I have a non-example over here. It's in orange because my camera doesn't pick up the red that great. And I've got a sharp bend in here, so this would not be a differentiable function. So if it is smooth and continuous, then it says that f of b minus f of a over b minus a, so we're just going to take these two x and y coordinates, find the slope of this secant line, and somewhere within that open interval of AB, there is a third point of C, a third X value, such that if you plug it into the first derivative and find the instantaneous rate of change, or the slope of the tangent line, that the slope of the tangent line is going to be equal to the slope of the secant line going through A, F of A, B, F of B. Over here, I've attempted to, it's a little bit sloppy here, but I've sort of got this curve going on here, but I did put a sharp bend just to illustrate that, you know, I just drew a picture, I don't know what these actual equations are making this function, but if I draw a couple of points and I mark it on the function, again, at the closed interval of AB, I can draw a secant line through those points, and I've identified a point on the function where f prime of c appears to have the same slope, the tangent line appears to have the same slope as the secant line, but this would not fit the average, the mean value theorem, because I've drawn a function with a sharp bend and you can't find the derivative at a sharp bend. So within the open interval of AB, this function would not be differentiable throughout that entire open interval. So this is sort of a non-example of what this mean value theorem is talking about. Let's take a look at two examples. The first one's pretty basic, and the last example is a little bit more of an advanced question, and hopefully will, or example, hopefully help you with a few of your homework problems. Bam! So here we have our first example. Determine whether the mean value theorem can be applied to the function on the closed interval of AB, and if possible, find all values of C in the open interval AB such that f prime of C, or the instantaneous rate of change, is equal to the average rate of change. So let's go ahead and find the derivative. If this is f of x is equal to x squared minus 2x minus 4, this is just a basic polynomial. We understand now that those are smooth and continuous curves, so this is going to be differentiable on the whole domain, I mean, from negative infinity to positive infinity. So f prime of x is equal to 2x minus 2. Okay, so that instantaneous rate of change needs to be equal to the average rate of change somewhere, and that value will be identified as c. So we need to find the average rate of change. So we're going to, you know, work through f of b minus f of a over b minus a. This will be a, and this will be b, our lower and upper bound. So you do want to read slope as, you know, left to right. So we want to go, we want to have our larger value be the value b, since it's first within the slope formula. average rate of change formula. So we have the average rate of change is equal to let's see here. With the 5, we've got 5 squared minus 2 times 5 minus 4. That's the, I got a lot going on here, so I'm going to use parentheses, make sure I don't use any make any sign errors. Minus parentheses, we're going to do the same thing with the 3. So 3 squared minus 2 times 3 minus 4 all over b minus a, so it's going to be 5 minus 3. So we have 5 squared is 25, 25 minus 10 is 15, and 15 minus 4 is 11, minus, we've got 3 squared, which is 9, here we have negative 6, so 9 minus 6 is 3, and 3 minus 4 is negative 1, all over 5 minus 3, which is 2. 5 minus 3, which is 2, and negative 11, or 11 minus negative 1, of course, is addition, so this becomes 12 divided by 2, or 6. So the average rate of change, the slope of the secant line going through the a value, or going through that, well, that didn't work out, oh yeah, I got it right here, going through 3, or 5, 11, and 3, negative 1, that slope of that secant line is equal to 6. So, can we find a value of C such that the slope of the instantaneous rate of change, or the slope at that value of C, is there a value of C which makes the first derivative, the slope of the curve, the slope of the tangent line, equal to 6? Well, I think so. It's a pretty basic formula here. So, F prime of X, or we're looking, again, we're looking for C, the slope. Well, that's going to be 6 is equal to 2X minus 2, add 2 to both sides, we get 8 equals 2x, and x equals 4. So this actually becomes, you know, our c value, where if I take the 4 and I plug it into the derivative, 4 times 2 is 8 minus 2 is equal to 6, and that instantaneous rate of change, or the slope of the tangent line, there's a c value that makes that derivative equal to the average rate of change. And that's just, you know, that's the mean value theorem. The only thing that really makes these questions a bit more difficult is if you have a function that's harder to find the derivative of than my basic polynomial here.